Good morning, students. How are you? Fine, no? Okay. Welcome to the history class. Today, I would like to discuss with you about the Vedic age. Vedic age in India, surely in India, Vedic age. And in the Vedic age, when we say Vedic age, number one, Vedic age is divided into two, early Vedic age and later Vedic age. So, today we will discuss the early Vedic age, and if it is possible, we will also continue with the later Vedic age. So, in short, I have discussed with you in live class, yet the video is for all those students who could not join the class, live class. So for them, only just a summary of it, short discussions and concluding. So who the Vedic age, before that, who are the people who were living during the Vedic age? How this Vedic age came to be? We know, we have heard about the coming of Aryans. Aryans, who are the Aryans? Aryans were the people who were living in the Eurasian steppes. Eurasian steppes means grass line of Eurasia. There they were living because they were herdsmen. They were herders, keeping up the cattle and sheep and goats. So they were living near the Caspian Sea, around that area of Eurasia. Eurasia, please remember that, Eurasia. I'll surely not tell what is Eurasia is, which part of the world is known as Eurasia. And so they were living there. When they were chased out by the Europeans, when Europe started developing, they needed more land and all that, so they were chased. And so they came in search of the pasture for their cattle. And then they, when they came here through the passage of a mountain passage of Himalaya, and then there they landed up in the Indus Valley region. Here it was beautiful, good pasture, enough of water and all that. So nice. So they named this land, when they came here, they named this land Brahma Avatara. What is that? Brahma Avatara. So first name in the northern India, Indus Valley region, was given the name as Brahma Avatara. Brahma Avatara. Because Brahma has given from them. Because they believed in Brahma. Brahma is the creator god, and then, who has created the whole nature, that they believed. And so they told it is a Brahma Avatara. They settled over there. And they settled and they did not move. So they started living a settled life. And when they were more in numbers, they started moving. And when they settled here, when they were not settling, they had not much of work, except the herd, keeping up the herds. But now they have a lot of work. Some started farming, some started making pots, some started making crafts, that is the tools to do the farming and all that. And so there was enough work. Some started spinning and all that. But there were some people who were sitting and thinking about the God and the reality, the nature. And so slowly, slowly they started writing the ways, the praise of God. Ah, God, you have given this land. You are the very good God and all that. He started praising. So all this hymn of praise put together. And then, so they started framing the Vedas. That we call it Veda. So during this region. Now, I am not giving exact time. So Brahma Avatara, they said. So, the first phase, that is coming and settling down, and then Then they came, they started writing. Then started settled life. Then there came the political life. Political life of the early Aryans. Then social life, economic life, all these are there. So, political life. Somebody started, the huge people, those who were Dadas, they became king. Then their occupation, farming was occupation. Then the social life, they started, there was a marriage, social, and then feast and festival, they started celebrating. And so, they in the social life, they made the group, because they had the different work. People started doing different work. So according to their work, according to their occupation, they divided the whole society into four groups. What were the first one? Those who were sitting and thinking about the God and all that, they were known as Brahmans, because they were in connection with the Brahma. So Brahma and Brahman, they were thinking about the creator God who has created such a wonderful world. And so they named it Brahmin. So it became Brahmin. Next one was the Kshatriya, those who were kings supposed to protect the people there. So they were protector of the people. They were known as Rajan. In English it is king. And so Kshatriya, they were known as Kshatriya. Their group name was Kshatriya. Next one was those who were doing the business, buying and selling the things, and the fulfilling the needs of the people. What is that? They were known as the Vaishyas. Vaishyas. And the last group, the lowest part of the society, was the Shudras. So Brahmans, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. These were the social divisions in the early life of the people during the Iron Age. All this happened during the Iron Age or Neolithic Age. And so all this were so there were people in the society. Many peoples were there. Next one is the political life, the economic life. Economical life was very, very flourishing. They were rich. They had plenty of herdsmen. They were producing and then different work. So they were, people were rich and prosper. Very nice. Next one, the religious life. People of the early Vedic age, they were very, very good. So they started performing the sacrifices, praising the God and doing the sacrifice, puja. They started puja. And so gods were prayed. They were praying to God and gone. There were different gods, nature god, like sun, moon, earth, water, fire. All these were different gods. Sun god, fire god, earth god, sky god, mountain god. All these different types of god were there. They were worshipping different types of gods. Nature god. That is about the early Vedic age. In the later Vedic age, my dear students, in the later Vedic age, what happened was that their political life of the people was more of organized. They started expanding. The kings were there. Sabha and Samiti were introduced. Then king used to show their power. So Ashwamedha Yajna and all that they were doing. So they had to show their power to expand their kingdom. And so there were Ashwamedha Yajna, Rajashu Yajna, then there was also one more Yajna was there. There were three Yajna: Rajashu Yajna, Ashwamedha Yajna, then another one was that is known as Vajpayee Yajnas. So there were three Yajnas. Social life of the later Vedic age. So surely here I want to remind you, tell you that in the early Vedic age, only one Veda was written. That is a Rig Veda. Vedic age, why you can call Veda? So there were four Vedas. Among the four Vedas, in the early Vedic age, they wrote one Veda known as Rig Veda. In the later Vedic age, there were three other Vedas. Which are the three other Vedas? Shama Veda, Yajurva Veda, Atharva Veda. Okay, all these Vedas were written afterwards in the later Vedic age. Later Vedic age. Next one, the social life. The social life of the people was made more of this. And so, social life of the people were was very very strange. Caste system was very very prominent. Caste system came. And so they did not want. So four ashramas, they developed into four ashramas in the later Vedic age. That is, what are the four ashramas? Number one is the brahmacharya, that is the student life, learning life. Then the grihastha is the household life and taking up the household work. Next one is the vanaprastha. Vanaprastha means going out into the forest and living the life of a rishi, a hermit. And the sannyasa. Sannyasa is the more sacrificial life. All that. Aham brahmasmi. All that. So sannyasa. These are the four ashramas. Please note that. Four ashramas. System of education was? System of education of ashram system. What was the language? Sanskrit was the language. How they were doing that? Everything was doing orally. No, written, writing things had not emerged. Though Rig Veda was written, Sama Veda, Atharva Veda, Yajurva Veda, all that we say, but it was not written. Those days it was not written, originally not written. It was passed on to the students or the people orally. Orally means by word. They were listening and then they were learning. That's why this is known as Shruti. Shruti came. Shruti and Sloka. Shruti and Sloka came. Those who are Hindi students, they will be able to tell me all those things. So that was there. So next one is the religious life, economic life was more prosperous, more people started different types of finding different types of work. Religious life was most composed. Brahmins were the superior above all, and there came the untouchability. The custom of untouchability came here. The later Vedic age. So the Shudras were kept away, but then they were serving all the other three classes of people, that is Brahmin, Kshatriya and Vaishyas. Shudras were the workers, lower part of the society, and so they had to do everything. So all these things are there in the Vedic age, during the Vedic age, all these things. So I have most summarized all this whole lesson into nutshell. Thank you. Please read the book and learn. Ask me in the live class any doubts you have.